Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Eli Aesthenics YouTube channel. If you didn't know, last Tuesday I had ACL surgery, and for those of you who have had that surgery done or a similar one done, you know that the recovery process isn't easy, nor is it short. It can take upwards of 9 months to a year for people to gain back full strength and ability level in that knee. And sometimes people say they never feel like they actually fully recover. And so going into the surgery, I continued thinking about all the things that I wasn't going to be able to do, whether it was leg exercises, workouts, cardio, doing crazy calisthenics skills, or even simple things like riding a bike. And as I continued to fixate on these thoughts, I began to have a negative outlook on the coming months of my life, and it created a frustration that began to consume my thoughts. And I continued to have this mindset even throughout the first few days after I got surgery, and it really just continued to add to the list of negative thoughts that I was having. And my dad sat us down in the living room as a family and said that he wanted us to watch a documentary called 7 Yards. And it's just a really inspirational story talking about a person who grew up in central Iowa, and he went to college football and suffered a paralyzing spinal cord injury. And despite all odds, he actually ended up walking again and walked to get his diploma after college. And it was really inspiring, but it made me realize that I was doing something catastrophically wrong. I was fixating my mind on all the things that I can't do instead of focusing on all the things that I'm still able to do. I was looking at my surgery simply as a trial and not as an opportunity. You see, even in the Bible, God tells us to use this mindset in James 1, where he says, "We're to count it as joy, brothers, when we encounter trials of various kinds." Everyone goes through hard things in life, and so it's really not a question of when, but it's really a question of how. It's a question of how can you see this trial as an opportunity to become stronger than you were before? How can you use this trial as an opportunity to become something that you weren't able to become if you hadn't gone through that season in your life? And how can you use this not as seeing it as something like a setback, but really seeing it as a step forward towards better things? And so that's what I did. I'm waking up every single morning with this uncomfortable brace in my leg, and I'm asking myself, how? How can I make today an opportunity to grow? How can I make today an opportunity to become a better version of myself that I wouldn't have been able to be if I'm not going through this season in my life? And so despite being in a brace, I'm still doing upper body workouts. I'm still trying to push myself and challenge myself in ways that I wasn't able to before. And I'm doing that all on top of my ACL rehab. I know that it's not easy and it's not going to be easy, but oftentimes the desirable results are not the ones that come the easiest. And I'm no longer just creating a list of exercises that I can't do or things that I can't do, but I'm finding ways to challenge myself with the workouts that I am able to do. And I realize if I want to look back and not have any regret about just going through the motions, then I need to implement this mindset into every single thing I do in my daily life. At the end of the day, there are two avenues of pain. Either you can go down the short-term pain of discipline, or you can suffer the long-term pain of regret. So no matter what you're going through, you need to change to this mindset. And you not only need to change your mindset, but you need to let your mindset change your actions and then see where it can take you. I hope you find this video inspirational or motivational to help you get through whatever it is that you're going through right now. And if you haven't seen one of my recent videos where I talk about how to get six-pack abs, make sure you go ahead and check that out. Make sure you comment down below any future video ideas you may have for me, and subscribe with notifications. That way you never miss a future video. I'll see you guys in the next video. All love. Peace out.